Why can't I stream from my old Mac?
So what are the minimum Mac specs for streaming? Do you need to upgrade or can you get by with what you already have? That's what we're gonna explore right now. Let's talk about the three most important Mac specs when it comes to live streaming. You've got CPU, GPU, and memory. But what do all the acronyms mean? You've heard the term CPU, Central Processing Unit, often referred to as just the processor, and really all that is how fast the computer is able to execute the tasks that you're asking it to do and how well it performs complicated tasks. And the memory of a computer is just like your memory. How many things can you keep in your head at once? It's the same thing for your computer. The more memory you have, the more things you can juggle all at once. GPU stands for Graphics Processing Unit. So why is that important exactly for live streaming? Well, if you think of a video as a series of images or graphics strung together quickly, which is all it is, then the GPU is in charge of processing each of those graphic images or frames 24, 30, or 60 times per second. And that's just the video coming in from a single camera source. Once you start adding in a second camera source, a third camera, animated graphics, an interview, or four, then you're asking it to process a ton more information and data. You're looking at 2, 10, or a gazillion times as much. Whew, that's a lot to process. If all you want is a basic live stream with audio and a single camera source, then pretty much any Mac built after 2015 should do the trick. You might be able to even get by with a 2013 MacBook Pro, but that could be calling it a stretch. So test, 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 and don't rely on it for any critical streams. Overall, really, we're recommending anything after 2015 as a minimum. Quick side note, these specs are really from our testing, but you may experience something different. Why, hello, girl. Based on a whole number of factors like the hardware that you have connected to your computer, the version of OS that you're using, or even the software that you have installed and or are using currently while you're streaming at the same time. Right, Abs? Why, thank you for coming over and saying hi. In other words, your mileage may vary. Are you learning a thing or two? Awesome! Hit that subscribe button and turn on that bell for notifications for more awesome content! Let's dive deeper into level 2 streaming specs. Level 2 streaming is what we call streaming from a browser-based service like Restream or StreamYard, and that requires a whole lot less processing power from your computer. For this, you're gonna wanna at least use a 2015 iMac or MacBook Pro with an Intel i5 processor and at least 8 gigs of memory. But if you wanna get fancy, you're gonna be safer relying on a quad-core Intel i7 processor. Now let's dive into level 3 streaming specs. Level 3 streaming is downloading software onto your computer like Ecamm Live or OBS, and the minimum specs that we recommend for this is at least a 2015 iMac or MacBook Pro with an Intel i7 processor and at least 16 gigs of memory. But if you're gonna get fancy with multiple cameras, guest interviews, animated graphics, you're sending your Ecamm output into Zoom, then the minimum specs you're looking at are 2017 iMac or MacBook Pro with a quad-core 2.9 gigahertz and 16 gigs of memory. Want to learn how all of the gear pieces fit together with your Mac? Well, in our studio workshop, we walk you step by step through the entire process of getting a professional video studio. Why is my computer so freaking slow? If you've ever asked yourself that, then just understand older computers do tend to slow down. There are a number of reasons for this, but one of the biggest reasons is software upgrades. As manufacturers want to take advantage of the latest and greatest machines, it's going to bog down your computer. That's just the way it goes. When you do have to upgrade, what specs should you prioritize? For the most part, Macs aren't upgradable after you purchase, so it's important to choose wisely whether you're choosing a Mac Mini, an iMac, or a MacBook Pro. By the way, at the time of this recording, check the date below, it does not make sense to buy anything older than an M1 for live streaming, okay? Got it, cool. So our recommendation is to look at your budget, then purchase the best option in each of these categories in this order. CPU and GPU. So Ecamm Live and any other streaming software like OBS rely heavily on that GPU and CPU. So if you have the option, you're gonna wanna choose the model with the higher CPU and graphics processor. Memory. You want as much as you can get. Now, while the M1 Macs seem to work great on 8 gigs of RAM, over time with software updates, this may wind up being on the lower end of what you actually need, so prioritize your spend here next. Storage. While 256 gigabytes of storage space can go a long way if your machine is dedicated to streaming only. However, the moment you start multitasking, you're doing other things on that machine, you're really gonna wanna consider going to 512 gigabytes or even more. Pro tip, if you use any services like Google Drive or Dropbox for syncing data to the cloud, then make sure you stop that background syncing or it will kill your stream. Now, that is one of many tips that I give you in the video linked to in the description, all about how to test your Mac for streaming to make sure you know if you need to buy or you can use what you got. You can attach a very fast Thunderbolt external drive. So if your budget is tight, then this would be your third priority. Just remember, these decisions should be made based on your timing and your budget, because the truth is, there's always a shinier, cooler new Mac just around the corner. Do not let that stop you from going live right now. I'll see you in the next video.